Hey everybody, and welcome back to 7-Minute AE Tutorials. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to make this water animation. You can use this for logo animations, text reveals, transitional elements, and much more. This is a very special episode because it's my 100th tutorial. Now, I've done quick tips, AE Studio episodes, and other videos like that, but this is my 100th actual tutorial. So for this one, I'm throwing out the 7-minute time limit, and we're just going to create something super cool that can be used in a variety of different ways and have fun. I really appreciate your support, and I hope you continue watching my tutorials. Please subscribe and click the bell so you get notifications. Join my channel for just $4.99 a month to get access to special deals and assets. Support us by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today in our store. And don't forget to check out my affiliates, Envato Elements and AE Juice. When you sign up with my affiliates, you get special deals because you are going through my channel. But more about that later. Links for all of that are in the description below. There's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so let's create a new composition. I'm going to call this Fractal Texture. 1920 by 1080, 2997 is okay, and I want to make this 10 seconds long. Command or Control Y to create a new solid. We will make this solid black, and I'm going to call this Fractal Noise. Click OK, and then let's go to our Effects and Presets, type in Fractal, double-click Fractal Noise. Okay, so first let's make the fractal type. We're going to make that dynamic. Make our contrast 130, our brightness negative 10. Let's open up our transform settings and let's just change the scale to 150. Put a keyframe for offset turbulence. Click on our layer, hit U to bring up that keyframe. Go down to the very end and we want to move 200 pixels in both the X and Y direction. So that'll be 1160 and on Y make that 740. Alt option click on evolution. Time times 100. So we have that kind of a look like that. Select the layer, go to effects and presets, and let's type in tritone. And we want to double click tritone. And I already have some colors that I've already pre-selected to get the right kind of look here. We want to set our highlights. Just click on that and put in this hex code right here. Click on our midtones. We want to set it to that blue. If we click on our shadows color, and change it to that blue. So here are the settings for our colors for this tritone. Create another composition. Just click this create new composition icon here and let's call this main. And now I want to drag in my fractal texture. So just drag that right into here. Let's go to our effects and presets and let's type in CC glass and double click on that. And now we need to make some changes to our surface settings. So let's change our softness to 40. Our height to negative 75, and our displacement to negative 100. So we kind of have this water texture that you can already see kind of happening here. And then let's just make this layer 3D, add in a new camera, and just click OK. It doesn't matter what setting it is. And let's also add in a new null object. We'll make that null object 3D and change it to camera control. Parent the camera to the camera control, P to bring up our position, and R to bring up our rotation. So let's just put a keyframe at the beginning for position, and then also one for Y and Z rotation. For our X rotation, let's go ahead and just tilt this back to 55 degrees like that. I want to fill the frame with our fractal texture, so bring up our scale, S for scale, and let's just increase this up to 250. Hold on Shift and P for position, and let's just kind of move this down to 130, so that way it sits a little bit low like that. I'm going to move this just so that way our water fills the whole screen. So now let's just move our Y position, maybe move this down a little bit. Put keyframes at the very end, so that way our Y rotation ends at 0, and our Z rotation will end it at negative 1. Go back to the very beginning of our animation and let's make this Y rotation start at negative 10. And so you just kind of tweak your position so that way you want to fill in the frame at all times. And maybe our Z rotation will make that negative 2. And then watch that play back and we kind of have this water movement like that. And now let's take our fractal texture here and Control or Command D to duplicate that. Then with this second fractal texture selected, let's go up to our Shape tool. And choose Ellipse tool and just double click on that. So that way we mask out the Precomp. Open up our mask settings and let's just change our feather to 150 and then our expansion to negative 150. If we solo that, we can kind of see how we kind of have this feathering around that. Okay, so let's make our scale, make that 160, so it's a little bit smaller. And then we want to move our position up to, say, like negative 75, so that way it sits a little bit higher than the other one. Decrease my opacity down to 65%. So we kind of have a little bit of a doubling effect here on our water. And then I want to duplicate this fractal texture one more time. Toggle switch our modes here, and I'm going to set this from normal to multiply. Bring up our scale, and let's increase this maybe to 200%, so it's a little bit larger. T for opacity, and we'll make this about 40%, so it's a little bit lighter. By layering these water layers, we get something that looks a little bit more realistic. Okay, so let's create a new composition. Let's go to this Create New Comp. I'm going to call this Text. Click OK, and I'm going to Command or Control T to bring up our text tool. I'm just going to type 7-minute AE tutorials. We'll make some changes of this text real quick. So let's go to our paragraph setting. We want to make sure it's centered, and then we can right-click, transform, center anchor point layer content, go to our align panel, and just center that right up. So you want to make sure that your text is always centered. If you want to change your text, come to this pre-comp, make the changes, and it will update across the entire animation. Let's go back to our main comp here. Now let's just drag in our text pre-comp so it sits right above the bottom fractal texture. So let's go ahead and toggle switch our modes back over and make this 3D. And then I want to go to our effects and presets. We're going to type in CC vector for CC vector blur. Double click that to add CC vector blur to this. We want our vector map to be set to our fractal texture. We want our map softness to be set to 30. And then let's go back to effects and presets and type in fast box for fast box blur. Double click that to add it. And then we're going to set our radius here to 5 pixels. That way it's a little bit softer. And then let's go back to our vector blur here. As you can see right now, it's not really having much of an effect at all. And that's because our amount has not been increased. So let's increase this amount to 15. I'm going to take off this fast box blur. We can see this is the effect that the CC vector blur is having, just to kind of make it look like it's sitting underwater. I'm going to toggle switch our modes again and set this to overlay. Duplicate that. Change our fast box blur settings from 5 to 10 just to kind of make it a little bit softer. I just want to pause for 1 second before we continue to recognize one of our affiliates, Envato Elements. Right now, they're offering a special discount for my subscribers, so if you haven't subscribed, make sure to click that subscribe button now. Get 1 free week of Envato Elements when you sign up today. That's 1 week to download as much as you want and really check out what they have to offer. They have After Effects and graphics templates, as well as fonts, sound effects and music beds, stock photos and videos, and so much more. Pretty much anything a serious motion graphic designer could possibly want or need. Now, this is only for a limited time, so don't miss out on this very special offer. This is something that Envato Elements hasn't done before, and it's only being offered through limited channels like mine. Check out the link in the description below and do not miss out on this amazing deal. Make sure you subscribe to take advantage of 1 free week of Envato Elements. Once you sign up, you'll never know how you designed and animated before using Envato Elements. Now, let's get back to our tutorial. So let's go back to our camera control settings and maybe, let me see, we'll move this down a little bit more. 960, 1050, and set this maybe to like 0. And then go down to our last keyframe here and we'll kind of play around with these settings. Let me take our fractal texture here and just maybe increase this a little bit more so that way it fills up more of the background. Mess with your camera settings to get the look that you want. I want to come in really close, that way we start like back there and it comes right up to us. If you want the same settings as I have, my position is 960, we'll say 1050 on the Y and 0 on the Z. And then this last keyframe at the 10-second mark would be 960, we'll say 240, maybe 150. So if you want the same look that I have, you can do those settings. So that way we kind of have this movement like this. Let's go to Layer, New. We want to create a new light. And we want this light, you want it to be a spotlight. Let's go ahead and set our intensity to 140. Let's open up our transform settings. Let's change our position. Let me see, we see 1040, 460. Maybe we'll go negative 3500. So that way we see more of the water here. So open up our light options. Set our cone angle. Let me see, we'll kind of play with this to get it the way you want it. Something about like that. I always like my cone feather to be at 100%. For our intensity, Option or Alt click on intensity and type in wiggle. 0.5, 10. It kind of gets brighter and then softer, but it's really slight. I'm going to actually change this to 0.515. Should I make this 55 degrees? Option alt click on the cone angle and type in wiggle 0.5 comma 7. So we just kind of have this like light effect that kind of comes in and out like that. If you select this top fractal, go to layer, new adjustment layer. That way it'll put an adjustment layer right above that fractal texture. I'm going to rename this to blur. Go to effects and presets, and we have fast box blur already selected. So let's just double click on that. Increase our blur radius up to 15. With blur layer selected, double click on the ellipse tool. Open up our mass settings, change this from add to subtract. So I just want to increase our feather and then kind of reshape this. Just something so you kind of get this blurring around the edges, but it's not like perfectly centered. And then maybe I'm going to move my spotlight, hit P for position, kind of move that up a little bit. So kind of have more of the edges kind of lit here. So I'm going to say 1040, 570, and negative 4000. I like to use rounded numbers if at all possible. Then I'm just going to change this to quarter quality because this is going to be a very, very heavy animation. And we can see how the text is integrated into this water animation. Now you can change the way this animates by adjusting your camera control setting. Maybe you don't want the tilt quite so extreme. You can kind of bring it up like that on the X rotation. You know, just kind of play around with this to get the look that you want. See, as I'm moving this, you can see the different layers of our water and how they kind of interact with one another and how they kind of sit there. So I'm going to put mine back to 55. Create another new composition here, and we're going to call this Final Water Animation. And now let's bring in our main pre-comp here. So first, let's go to effects and presets and just type in brightness. And we're going to add in a brightness and contrast. So double click that. Set our brightness maybe to 40 so we can kind of see a little bit better. Our contrast, I'm going to increase that to 20 to kind of give it a little bit punch. Maybe 30. If you can toggle that off and on, you can already see the difference that just adding that brightness and contrast makes. Go to layer, new, solid, and you can make this whatever color you want because we're going to make some changes to this. Go back to our effects and presets, type in fill. I'm just going to double click on generate fill. And I already have a color selected that's going to work with this. So if we just click on our color and use that fill color, this light pink. We want to toggle switch our modes. Okay, and then let's just make this mode. We'll change that to overlay. Take our pen tool, and I'm just going to kind of make a triangle over here for the bottom left half. Type MM to bring up our mass settings. We want to feather this up to 300 pixels. T for our opacity, and just lower this down about maybe 30%. So it's just kind of slight. Now you can toggle this off and on and kind of see how it adds a little bit of something. And you can increase this opacity depending on what it is you really want to get there. But I think that looks good. Maybe we'll go 50%. Okay, and I'm going to duplicate this black solid and just grab this lower left part of this mask, go over to the right, and kind of just reshape this. So we're going to the top right now. These are just some tweaks you can add in. It's not necessary that you do it, but I kind of like to add like a little bit of a polish at the end of my animations. I'm going to change this pink color down to a black, so that way we have it like that, where it's black. See, it just kind of adds in a little something extra. And again, you can toggle this off and on to see what the difference is if you include these overlays or not. Select our main layer here, go to effects and presets. I'm going to type in motion tile and double click motion tile. We want to mirror our edges and set our output width to 125, our output height to 125. And now with main selected, press P to bring up our position. And we're going to add in an expression. Option alt click position. Just going to type in wiggle 2, 4. And then I'm going to make this layer 3D. And then R to bring up our rotation. And I'm going to put a wiggle expression on all three of these rotations. So option alt click X rotation. I'm going to say wiggle 2, 3. Right click, copy expression only. Paste that onto our Y rotation and then paste it onto our Z rotation. Now if you type EE, it will bring up all of your expressions here. For our Y rotation, let's change this to 0.5, 1, so it's not quite as extreme. And then for Z, I want it to be a little bit slower, so 0.3, 1. So if you want your animation to look like mine, use these settings. So if you play that back, we can kind of see how it's going to move a little bit. It just has something that's like a little bit more organic and flows a little bit better. And that's our water animation. And again, you can tweak this. You can adjust the camera settings to get a different angle if you'd like. You can make those color overlays here. You can make these different colors. You can add in a lot more text, or you know, you can add no text if you'd rather have it where it's just the water effect. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers, is guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.